hide-and-seek sparrow. As a group, we think to and then reflect on your assigned character. Brainstorm ideas of how you and your group can display an act of Christmas kindness that reflects that character.
Ah, cake. Oh, Tucker, not that kind of cake. Okay, so which character do I have?
Let's see. Timmy has the innkeeper, Abby has the shepherds and the angels, Sarah has the wise men, Gracie, me, I have God, and Tucker. Tucker, it says you.
That's weird, but before we do anything else, let's read Luke 2 like Mr. Keller said.
Joseph went to Bethlehem to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with a child. While they were there, the day came for her to deliver. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger. Because there was no room for them in the inn, there were shepherds in the field keeping watch over their flock by night. An angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the God shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger." And praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men."
Me too. And this assignment makes me look at it a little different.
Yes, cake.
The innkeeper. I already have an idea. I'll have to talk to my dad first, but can you meet back here?
I'm kind of excited. This assignment might actually be fun.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bye.
This isn't a...
Your cake.
This isn't an inn, and why are these things? These aren't Irish for an inn.
We don't have an inn. We don't even own a house.
Right, of course. But when you think about the innkeeper, he didn't have rooms to give to Mary and Joseph either. But he did find a way to help them stay warm and keep dry.
But we all have homes that help us keep warm and stay dry.
Exactly. Right. But there are people in our city that don't have homes. In fact, you might find people without homes in places you don't even expect.
How can we help?
Like this. My dad helped me find a shelter, which is a place where I help people without homes. They can go there and find warm clothes and food and even sleep there. We can all go and give them some boxing items.
What a great idea, Timmy. This is definitely a Christmas act of kindness.
Come on, let's go. Okay.
Thank you.
Right being their favorite part of Christmas this year.
That was definitely an act of kindness I wanted to do again.
Yep, cake.
Okay, so it's my turn. I've been thinking about this one a lot.
Oh good, you have the wise men, right?
You got an easy one.
I did? How is it easy?
Well, they give gifts.
And we all give gifts at Christmas.
Yep, done. That was easy. Next.
Whoa, wait a minute. I actually don't think it's that easy. Yes, we all give gifts, but I don't think that's all there is to this experiment.
How come everyone was giving a gift?
Well, normally I just give gifts to my friends, family, and teachers, don't you? But what if we gave gifts to someone we don't know?
Someone we don't know, why would we do that?
Okay.
Fred Tucker, an act of kindness. The wise men didn't know Jesus. They knew about him, they hadn't met him or his mom or dad, but they still gave him gifts, really good and meaningful gifts.
So what does that mean for us?
My church gets gifts for families who wouldn't usually get gifts for Christmas. We can pick, buy, wrap, and deliver the gifts.
We could get things they need for school and new clothes. Oh, this is exciting.
I have some money from mowing yards that I could use to buy gifts.
Let's go. You're going to need... What are we waiting for? This actually may be my favorite part of the experiment.
Yes, cake.
Let the mountains move.
really had to think about this one. God's gift to us at Christmas is the greatest gift of Jesus. His gift reaches everyone. So I thought of ways we could reach our whole community. And Jesus is called the light of the world, so I thought with that huge box of Christmas lights, we could light up the whole town.
You mean everywhere?
Well, what about bringing light to the place we could point people to Jesus? The church! Yes, we're going to decorate and bring light by pointing our whole community to Jesus.
Assignment said you.
You? What does that mean?
You were a part of Christmas. correct, but listening to all of you and doing all the acts of kindness reminded me that I really am part of the story.
I'm not sure I understand.
I think the experiment was to help us see that our actions tell a story of the greatest gift of love.
You mean like the story of the innkeeper or the shepherds and the wise men?
Exactly. Those examples are for us to follow. And the ultimate example is in God's gift to us, Jesus.
Are you saying you're part of the Christmas story by giving the homeless guy a Christmas carol and buying gifts for strangers?
Or by pointing others to Jesus?
Exactly. These acts of kindness are how we show God's love to the world around us.
We can show the same love. God loves us so much, He sent Jesus. We can show the same love through our action.
So you're saying that Christmas isn't the only time of year we should give acts of kindness. It should be an everyday kind of cake.
As I've said before,
we all know cake!
The receiver.